national anthem. Bright skies overhead and hopes on the parts of both East and West. The 1956 Grey Cup game between the Montreal Alouettes coming out from the south end of the stadium. Let's have a look as they come onto the field through the line of drum majorettes. White pants with red stripes down the side, red sweaters, white numbers front and back, and red helmets with a white stripe down the middle of it, and of course the red stockings. Both teams very cognizant that this is the third meeting in a row of the Edmontons and the Montreals. Edmonton, of course, having won both previous games by scores of 26-25 2 years ago and 34-19 last year. Of course, there's all sorts of psychological reasons for the Montreal Alouettes to want to win this one, just as many for the Edmonton Eskimos to want to make it three in a row and thus join only two or three other teams in the history of the game who have been able to win three games in a row. Now for the official kickoff. Point just as to who will kick off out there. They've got the ball teed up, but about 16 people all set, and there it goes. And in the rush, you can almost see 5 feet go forward and only one ball go down the field. One of the finest ceremonial kickoffs since Viscount Alexander did it a few years ago.
Doug, I think we are getting pretty close to kickoff time here. The Edmonton Eskimos will kick off to the Montreal Alouettes. Alouettes will defend the goal to our right on your TV screen as you look at it. That is the south end of Varsity Stadium. The football is being fixed firmly on the tee at the Edmonton 45-yard line. Play-by-play in the first quarter, it's Ted Reynolds.
Thank you, Steve. Joe Mopra, number 77, will kick off from his own 45-yard line. The deep men are Patterson in the middle with Powell and James. The kick goes wide to the right and out of bounds at the Montreal 25, and we'll do that all over again. Trying to keep that ball away from the dangerous Patterson, Mopra picks up a 10-yard deficit for the Edmonton club by kicking the ball out of bounds. Trying to keep that ball away from the dangerous Patterson. Mopra picks up a 10-yard deficit for the Edmonton club by kicking the ball out of bounds and will do it over again from his own 35. Edmonton to our left, the north end of Varsity Stadium. Patterson in the middle, Powell to his right, and on his left, number 99, James. They're standing now at about their own 15-yard line. And once again, referee Harry Bowden gets them set, and the kick comes from the 35. There's the whistle, there's the boot. It's short, bounces at the 30, being picked up by Powell. Powell is smeared just as he gets across his own 35-yard line. The first man down in there, number 54. And number 83, Jim Shipka. So immediately the Edmonton defense changes, and the starting team that was given to you by Steve Douglas goes in. Kometch and Berry were both in for the kick. It's Alouette, first and 10, the first running play of the game, and Etcheverry, handoff to Abruzzi. Abruzzi whirls and dives across his own 45-yard line. And that's going to be close to a first down. Hand off to Abruzzi. The tackle was made by Oscar Kruger, and they're going to measure on the first running play of the game. That offensive line for Montreal: Patterson, Stat, Staten, Gibbons, Tom Hugo is the center, Trollick, Golder, and O'Quinn. The ends are number 73, Red O'Quinn, and number 75, Hal Patterson. Now, a flanker sent wide to the left. Sam Etcheverry calling signals. They were less than a yard from the first down, and Etcheverry is going to throw. It's the long, long pass down to the 30-yard line. It was meant for number 86, Bob Pascal. He could not quite get under it, so it will be third and still about a foot and a half to go for the Montreal Alouettes. Pascal was the intended receiver. Third down, Montreal. Kimoff charged in. He is the linebacker who has taken Lindley's place. There's the handoff. Abruzzi whirls, gets across the 50 to the midfield stripe before being snowed under by a maze of Edmonton tacklers. And Abruzzi goes for the first down. Bill Rokamp, number 74, led the assault along with John Tatum, who came up from his inside linebacker position. Edmonton in the 5-4 defense. Now Etcheverry flanks the man wide to the left. The handoff is to James. James across the 45, the 40. And he's finally pulled down after rolling for another first down to the Edmonton Eskimos 30. Almost the 35-yard line, just inches short. Rolling Miles, number 98, finally moved in to stop James. And it's first and 10 for the Montreal Alouettes, who are rolling with a vengeance here in the early seconds of the first quarter of this Grey Cup game. Now it's James, a flank wide to the left. Flankers left and right. The handoff goes to Pascal. He moved across the Edmonton 35 and was stopped in there by number 42, John Tatum, who is the offensive center and the defensive left inside linebacker for the Edmonton Alouettes, taking the place of the great Kurt Burris, who was one of the stars of last year's championship team. Now flankers left and right. Etcheverry going back to pass. The rush is on him, and he's downed for a big loss. A loss of about 7 yards. The big rush put on him, and leading the attack in there was Frankie Anderson, one of the great defensive ends of Canadian football. Third down, 15 yards to go. Montreal will kick for the first time in the game. Sam Etcheverry will kick, standing back at the 55. Your deep men are Steve Mendrick and Rolly Miles. Mendrick on the near side. The kick bounces, picked up by Mendrick. And Mendrick is hauled down after just getting back across his own 5-yard line. And the defensive team for the Montreal Alouettes goes in. The tackle was made by Doug McNichol, number 74, and number 67, Ted Elsby, who is taking the place of Staten. Only 37 yards, that kick by Sam Etcheverry. Of course, the first punt of the 1956 Grey Cup game. And here come the Eskimos. offensively for the first time in the game, and Parker is in at quarterback to start the game. That, of course, was the big question. Who would be at quarterback? And on the first play, the handoff went to Normie Kwong. Kwong moved across his own 10. It's second and 5 for the Edmonton Eskimos. Big Billy Ship, number 68, made the stop. There's the Don Getty in at quarterback, and the handoff. No gain on that one. They got just across the 10, perhaps. Johnny Bright was the ball carrier. Moran came in. Dex Coulter. And the Eskimos are forced to kick after getting no place in their first series of offensive plays. The benches are immediately below us. Deep man, Karpuk on the far side, closest to you, Joey Powell, number 82. Edmonton Eskimos forced to kick from their own 12-yard line. Jackie Parker standing inside his own goal line, gets it away. It's a good kick. Coming down to the 55, where it's taken by Karpuk. Karpuk turns and gets back just across the 55-yard line before being snowed under, with Don Berry leading the charge down there, along with Big Bill Briggs, one of the real veterans of the Edmonton Eskimo team. And the Alouettes take over just inside Edmonton territory on the Edmonton 54-yard line. That kick of Jackie Parker's traveled 44 yards. There's Sam Etcheverry giving his team their instructions in the huddle. He sends only 11 men on the field. There's a handkerchief, the first one. On the handoff, the ball was moved ahead to the 51. Elsby, number 67, was the player who forgot to move in. He has replaced Satan, and he wasn't out there for that play. That was the first penalty of the 56 Grey Cup game. And it moved the ball back to the Montreal 51. First down over again, 15 yards to go. There's Etcheverry looking for the receiver, and the long pass meant for James. Knocked down, almost intercepted. Bill Rokamp went high in the air and almost had that ball in his clutches as he was defending very well. He almost hung onto it, but he was high in the air and lost his balance just as he knocked the ball down. So it's second down, 15 for the Montreal Alouettes. We've played just on 3.5 minutes of the 1956 Grey Cup game from Varsity Stadium in Toronto, and there's no score. It's Montreal Alouettes, second and 15 at their own 51-yard line. Pascal is flanked wide to the left. Etcheverry drifts out to his left, slips, the rush is put on him, and he is snowed under for another big loss back at his own 40-yard line. Bill Walker came charging in there from defensive right end. Bill Walker came storming in that time to throw Etcheverry for his second big loss this early in the game. Alouettes are forced to kick. Etcheverry drops back to his own 27. Your deep men are Miles and Steve Mendrick. Mendrick closest to us. Etcheverry gets away another rather short kick taken by Roley Miles at the 35. Putting a little slippery, Miles dances back across his own 40, where he is brought down by number 54, Marty Martinello. And the Edmonton Eskimos have the football. And there is no score in the game. Montreal, no score. Edmonton Eskimos, no score. Number 65, Bruce Coulter, intercepting a Jackie Parker pass on the first play with Getty at quarterback. Kwong on a handoff had gone 2.5 yards. On the second play, the split-tee option with Parker throwing the pass interception by the Alouettes, who take over at the Edmonton 45, first and 10. Etcheverry with the pitch out to Abruzzi. Abruzzi being chased. Ducks away from one man. A beautiful block, and he rolls down across the 40. A tremendous block in there by Red O'Quinn. Gave him an extra 5 yards. Tully, number 70, finally came up to put the stop on Abruzzi, who has looked dynamite in the early stages of this game. When Abruzzi's had the ball, he has moved it. The gain is 7 yards. It's second and 3 for the Montreal Alouettes at the 38-yard line of the Edmonton Eskimos. Now they pitch out to the left. Again to James. James finds a big hole and is finally pushed over and rolled out of bounds to the sidelines after getting inside the 25. Johnny Bright got to him first, and he was finally pushed out by Big Roger Nelson. Billy Shipp threw the key block to cut Abruzzi loose as he took the handoff from Sam Etcheverry, and the Alouettes, threatening now, have it first and 10 inside the 25-yard line. Etcheverry's handoff is to the second man, Abruzzi, across the 20-yard line. And Anderson again, number 51, is in there to put the stop on the hard-charging Montreal fullback. Frankie Morris, the middle guard, number 52, the former Toronto veteran, a real veteran of Grey Cup football, is also in on that tackle. Now the S tighten up their defenses, and they're in almost an eight-man line. The handoff this time is to Pascal. Pascal spins, gets across the up to the 15-yard line before he was stopped by number 42, Johnny Tatum. Pascal got about 2 on the carry. And now the Montreal fans, who are down here from Montreal by the thousands, start to chant at their big red team to go. It's 3rd and 3. Etcheverry flanks 2 men wide to the right. Hand off is to Abruzzi. He gets running room, spins across the 10, and down to about the 8-yard line of the Eskimos, as that Eskimo forward wall is being outcharged by the big Montreal line. Oscar Kruger, number 94, and Johnny Tatum, number 42, came in to put the stop on Abruzzi, who has been the payoff man so far in this first quarter for the Montreal Alouettes. 9 minutes unofficially remaining in the first quarter, and it's a scoreless football game, but the Alves have the first big threat going. It's first and goal to go for the Alouettes. Etcheverry on the keep, and there's the lateral to Patterson. He's over in the corner for a touchdown. Cal Patterson, and Montreal's Mr. Wonderful comes through for the Eastern champions, who lead by a score of 6-0. Following the interception by Bruce Colder, the Alouettes traveled 45 yards in 6 plays. Montreal 6, Edmonton no score. Bill Buehle, number 80, will attempt the convert with Sam Etcheverry holding. The ball is down, and the kick is good. It was 6, but it's good, and the score, the Montreal Alouettes, 7. Edmonton Eskimos, no score. And this, of course, is the first Grey Cup game featuring the 6-point touchdown. The scoring play was the lateral pass to Patterson, who went over unmolested in the corner. If it means anything, 2 years ago, Edmonton scored first in the Grey Cup game here. Last year in Vancouver, Montreal put the initial points on the scoreboard. Johnny Blacher, number 81, will kick off for Montreal from his own 45. Parker and Miles back inside their own 10. It's the short kick. It's picked up and dropped by Johnny Bright finally plows forward. And that Montreal forward wall is really down and in there. Number 62 who plowed in that time was Bob McClellan. The ball carried back to the 30. Kwong finally carried it as Bright was standing and looking at it for a moment or two. And the Eskimos come up over the ball. They trail 7-0. Done. Handoff is to Parker, and Parker plows forward across the 35 to the 38-yard line of the Alouettes before being stopped by Doug McNichol. Number 74. Parker picked up almost 8 yards. It's second and two. Don Getty, the quarterback. Handoff is the first man, Bright, who piles through across his own 45-yard line for a first down for the Edmonton Eskimos. Bruce Colder moved up from his safety position to make the stop along with Bill Buehle, number 80. First and 10 for the Edmonton Eskimos at their own 46-yard line. There is the pitch out to Bright, and Bright dives across the 50 to about the 53-yard line. Number 72, Jim Miller, was the man who got to him with a good low tackle. And you have to hit Bright low. He's an explosive type of runner, that charging fullback for the Edmonton team. Now Getty with a pitch out again to Bright. And Bright gets running room down across the 55-yard line for a first down for Edmonton. And the Eskimos are rolling a bit on the ground. In there, right at the bottom of the pile, was number 50, Art Walker, who threw a key block. The stop was made by Big Tom Hugo, the veteran center and inside linebacker of the Montreal Alouettes, along with Jim Miller, number 72. Montreal using the straight Ivy split tee. It's Parker, pushed out of bounds. He danced across the 50 on one foot. Bill Buehle had a hold of him. Parker picked up. Give him 3 yards. It'll be second and 7 for the Edmonton Eskimos, who have the ball inside Montreal territory. Alouettes leading 7-0. The touchdown by Hal Patterson. Now they flank Parker out to the left, and Getty's going to throw for the first time. He's rushed. He's screened. It was meant for Rollie Miles, who was charged in there by Juan Sheridan. Big number 64, Getty's first pass attempt. He got the defenders in, but he couldn't get Rollie Miles sprung loose. Karpuk and Pal, the deep men, doing the booting is Jackie Parker from his own 50. He gets away a short spiral that goes out of bounds at the about the 17-yard line of the Montreal Alouettes, who'll take over their first and 10. And here's the score. Montreal 7, Edmonton no score. Montreal first and 10. They marked that ball out at about the 27-yard line. Etcheverry with the handoff to James, who gets across the Montreal 30, a gain of about 5 yards. Make it 4.5. Second, 5.5 yards to go. John Tatum made the tackle, number 42 for the Edmonton Eskimos. There have been no substitutions from the original starting teams yet. Edmonton using a 5-4-3 now. Etcheverry with the screen pass to Pascal, and Pascal is pulled down. A very fine tackle over there at the 35-yard line. Jackie Parker was in there very quickly, along with Rollie Miles. There's a gain of no more than a yard. It's third down, and the Montreal team will kick from just inside their own 35-yard line. Etcheverry standing back at his own 20. The Edmonton deep men at their own 37-yard line. There's the kick. Etcheverry gets away his best kick of the day. It's taken by Miles at the 40. And Miles is met head-on by Jim Miller, number 72, and he went not one inch farther. You may have noticed Miles slipping a bit. It is a little greasy out there now. Echeverry's kick traveled 37 yards from the point at which the ball was scrimmaged. And there's not been a really brilliant kick in this football game yet. Al's leading by a score of 7-0. 6 minutes remaining in the first quarter. Now the pitch out from Getty is to the China Clipper. He got nowhere as number 77, Tommy Moran, came in to put the stop on him. Gain of perhaps a yard, no more. It's second and 9 for the Edmonton Eskimos, who have been defended very well by this Montreal team so far in this game this afternoon. Now Getty is going back to throw again. It's the long pass complete to the 50-yard line of the Montreal Alouettes. Bill Walker. Offensive right end. Cut in to take that pass, and it's first and 10 for the Edmonton Eskimos. Don Getty with his back to you, number 87. The youngster from Western calling the plays and completing that long pass. Now it's the handoff on the reverse to the left, Rolly Miles, and he's pushed out of bounds on the 40. That's the counterplay on the split D. And Edmonton has not tried anything fancy, really, in that backfield so far. Some people, but funnily enough, mostly people from the East, were predicting they might try something. The ball is at the 41. It's second and 4. Getty's handoff is to the first man, and the ball is moved to the 35-yard line. It's enough for a first down. Johnny Bright bowled through to the 35, where it's first and 10 for the Eskimos, who are threatening for the first time in the game. Big Billy Shipp, number 68, who's been devastating in there so far today, was the man who put the stop on him. Getty's handoff was to the first man, Kwong, and Kwong moves down across the 30 to about the 28, closer to the 27-yard line, before being stopped by Bill Buehle, number 80. Second and 3 for the Eskimos, and Getty has them moving on the ground. Now Getty's handoff is to the second man. Carpock came in to put the stop on Jackie Parker. Jackie Parker. I suppose if you turn Parker around, you get Carpock out of it almost. It's first and 10 with 5 minutes remaining in the first quarter. The Eskimos, first and 10 inside the Montreal Alouettes 25-yard line. And Don Getty has the white and gold and green from Edmonton moving. Now it's Getty faking the handoff. He gets good protection. There's the long pass just over the outstretched arms of Bill Rokamp, away down in the end zone. And Rokamp got in there very neatly, but Getty threw it over him a little bit, and Colder was in there very quickly covering. So those who predicted that we might see quite a bit of passing from Getty may be right. Eskimos trailing, of course, in this first quarter. They want to get back. It's the faked handoff and the pitch out to Parker. Parker with the lateral to Miles. Miles across the 20, rolls forward before moving out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. There's another classic play from the split T formation. Above the 17-yard line. It's third and 3. They're going to go for it. They come out in running formation. Getty gives it to the payoff man, Kwong, who spins down across the 15, and it looks as though he has the first down. We'll wait till they unfile. First down for the Edmonton Eskimos. Big Juan Sheridan, number 64, got Kwong, but he couldn't get him quite quickly enough. Army Kwong, who so far in his career has scored 20 points in Grey Cup games. There's a handoff to Miles, who finds a hole. Moves down across the 5-yard line. Rolly Miles cutting across from the right, moved to the four-yard line before being stopped again by Bruce Colter, who has been playing a fine defensive game for Montreal. So it's second down and three to go. Four for a touchdown. Bright across. Johnny Bright over for an Edmonton Eskimo touchdown. Johnny Bright taking the handoff from Don Getty, pulled his way across left tackle, and the score is Montreal Alouette 7, the Edmonton Eskimos 6. Joe Mobra, number 77, will attempt the conversion. Just under 4 minutes unofficially remaining in the first quarter. We give you that time unofficially as the official time is kept on the field. Don Getty will hold, number 87. Joe Mobra, number 77, will kick. The ball is down. The kick is no good. It's wide to the left. And the score remains Montreal Alouette 7, the Edmonton Eskimos 6. The Eskimos went 68 yards in 11 plays. The long gain, of course, came off Getty's pass to Bill Walker. So there's a one-point spread. As we approach the end of the first quarter of what so far has been a very well-played Grey Cup game under ideal conditions. The middle of the field is perhaps a little greasy, but there's been not too much slipping. Miles, a couple of times, has slipped a little bit on receiving kicks. Pal, Patterson, and Dub James are your deep men. The kick off for Edmonton by Mobra from the 45. He slants it across to Joey Powell, and again it goes out of bounds, as occurred in the opening kickoff, and again they'll take it back 10 yards. They're trying to keep that ball away from Patterson. Trying to slant that ball away from the always dangerous Hal Patterson. Twice now, Mobra has kicked it a little too far wide. And there, for the benefit of Vancouver fans, if you happen to hear a trumpet, is a Vancouver trumpet blowing just down below us under a very wide sombrero. Mobra kicking this time from his 35. And he gets it away, a short kick. It's coming to James at his own 30. James finding running room, gets a good block, and then it's met head-on, a full-like charge. Boy, he was snowed under hard down there. And the first man in was Bill Briggs, the big Edmonton defensive star, a veteran of the club. And the Eskies send in their defensive team. The Montreal Alouettes have the football first and 10 at their own 41-yard line. Etcheverry has two men flanked wide to the right. His handoff is to a Bruzy. Bruzy finds a hole over left tackle and gets down across his own 50-yard line. A big gain again by Pat Abruzzi. Number 64, Mike Vulcan. He came in to put the stop on him. First down for the Montreal Alouettes. At their own 52. And it was supposed to be the aerial attack against the ground attack. Well, Edmonton has shown the ground attack, but so has Montreal. When Abruzzi has had that ball, he has rambled. Abruzzi, who had a very disappointing Grey Cup game last year, is certainly showing signs of making up for all that. Again, two men flank very wide to the right. There's the jump pass down to the 47 to Red O'Quinn. The little pro pass right over the line of scrimmage, taken by Red O'Quinn at the 46-yard line. He was stopped by Oscar Kruger. It's another first down for the Alouettes at the Edmonton 46-yard line. 3 minutes remaining in the first quarter. There's the indication from the referee to the benches. They're immediately below us. Montreal just to our right, Edmonton just to our left. We're right over the Edmonton 50-yard line. Edmonton defending the north end to our left. There's the pass knocked down. It was meant for Patterson that time. But charging in was his opposing number 75, Bill Walker. And it's second and 10. Steve has just pointed out to me that Etcheverry has not completed. He's completed 1 in 5, which is indeed a rarity for Sam Etcheverry. Now he's going to throw again. He does. It's caught by Patterson at the 36, and he moves across the 35. He's thrown back, but advanced the ball to about the 33-yard line of the Edmonton Eskimos before being stopped by Joe Mobra, number 77. Joey Powell is flanked wide to the right. James on this side. Abruzzi on the fullback draw gets across the 30 to the 33-yard line, the 27-yard line. Make it the 28. It's second and 5. The stop was made by John Tatum. Montreal Alouettes leading the Edmonton Eskimos 7-6 late in the first quarter. Powell again, number 82, flanks wide to the right. James on this near side. And Etcheverry is going back to throw. He gets good protection. The pass is grabbed by Powell and then dropped. He was hit hard by John Tatum, number 42, the Edmonton Eskimo left inside linebacker, who rocked Powell, and the pass goes incomplete. It's third and 5 at the 28-yard line of the Eskimos. 2 minutes remaining now, a little less than 2 minutes on the unofficial scoreboard clock in the first quarter. James is wide to the left again. Powell to the right. Etcheverry is going to throw. It's in the ground. It was meant for Patterson, but Patterson either cut in just a shade late or Etcheverry figured he had to throw a little too early. But Patterson was not there when the ball was. So the Montreal Alouettes lose the ball on down. And the Edmonton Eskimos, who trail them 7-6 late in the first quarter, take over first and 10 at their own 28. 5-yard penalty. Getty calling signals. There's that Edmonton long count. And they pulled about 5 Montreal Alouettes offside. I think the Edmonton team was offside as well. They were both offside, the official indicates. Edmonton will use that long count. Both teams were offside that time, so it didn't work. Big number 60 will bull through first for Montreal is Tex Colder. Now Getty with the quick count. The handoff, and the ball is moved across the Edmonton 35-yard line. A gain of about 4 yards by Roley Miles, number 98. Tex Colder, number 60, and McNichol in to put the stop on him. We heard that Montreal might use 2 middle guards, more or less, and they do at times push that man up for a split 6 defense. There's Parker taking the pitch out and being rushed out of bounds at the 38-yard line. And Parker for the Edmonton team and Patterson of Montreal are both getting very, very special attention from the defensive unit on each side. When Patterson gets that ball, he's ganged, and the same is true for Jackie Parker. So the Edmonton Eskimos are forced to kick again. Third down and 6 to go. They'll kick from their own 37-yard line. Karpuk and Powell are back, standing at their own 30, and this time it's Walker kicking. A high short kick taken at the 40 by Powell. He's being chased and is hauled down after getting just across his own 40-yard line. think Frankie Anderson again was in there. That's the first time Walker has kicked in the game. Parker kicked the first two punts for the team from the West. And the minute flag is up in the first quarter. Montreal leading by a score of 7-6. The flag is up. Sam Etcheverry will start the Alouettes, moving again from his own 43. Etcheverry with the pitch out to Pascal across the 50 to 55. And he's finally hauled down. And for the first time in the game, a couple of the boys get a little animosity brewing, but it's nothing particularly serious. And Pascal rolls for the first down. Number 70, Ted Tully of the Edmonton Eskimos, along with Anderson, in to make the stop. It's first and 10 for the Alouettes. That minute flag is still waving down there. Etcheverry rolls to the right. Good block. He's still going. Pitch out to James, and James puts his head down and plows to the 50. A gain of about 4 yards on the play. Make it three. It's second and 7 for the Montreal Alouettes, who again are inside Edmonton territory. They have it second down, 7 to go at the Edmonton 50. Etcheverry calling signals. Flanker wide to the left. There's the pass. It was meant for James. He just couldn't reach it, and there's the gun to end the first quarter of the Grey Cup game and the score. The Montreal Alouettes, 7. The Edmonton Eskimos, 6. The teams have changed ends. This time, Montreal will be to our left, defending the north end. The Edmonton Eskimos to our right at the south end of Varsity Stadium. And here to bring you the second quarter of what so far is a scintillating Grey Cup game, here is Steve Douglas.
Right, Ted, the ball is on the 50-yard line, Edmonton end of the field. Mendrick and Miles are the two deep men. Sam Etcheverry will boot from his own 50. It is third down, about 8 yards to go. 7-6, the Alouettes. High floater taken by Miles at the 15-yard line. Running diagonally, laterals to Mendrick at the 25, 30, at the 40-yard line, pushed out of bounds on the 43-yard line. And Sam Etcheverry, who did the kicking, went all the way across to the far side, the east side of Varsity Stadium, and pushed Mendrick out of bounds after he took the lateral from Raleigh Miles. 32-yard kick. As Ted pointed out, there hasn't been a mammoth boot all afternoon. As a matter of fact, I don't believe there's been one over 40 yards from the line of scrimmage. Edmonton's ball, first and 10 from their own 43-yard line. Geddie is quarterbacking. Handoff is to Johnny Bright, that quick burst that we were so familiar with last year in Vancouver, and how that big boy does move. Juan Sheridan, number 64 of the Alouettes, is one man in on that tackle. And Jack Dwyer, number 89. Dwyer playing left half defensively. 23 yards on that tremendous, sudden, powerful burst through the middle by big Johnny Bright, who scored the Eskies' only touchdown so far. Miles on the pitch out from Geddie. Miles throwing, intended for Parker, intercepted and dropped by Hal Patterson. Well, there you had the two top players so voted in the country this year up against each other. On the pitch out to Raleigh Miles from quarterback Don Geddie. Miles came about 10 or 15 yards toward these western sidelines, then hurled it down, intended for Parker, and Patterson almost had the interception but couldn't hang on. Second down and 10 yards to go. The football is about 18 yards in from the far side of the field and is on the Alouettes 43-yard line, Edmonton possession. The cut is to Miles again. The pitch out from Miles to Parker. And Hal Patterson hits him low around the left ankle and helps drag him down. Doug McNichol came in. So did John Blacher. And Bruce Calder, number 65. So the kicking team comes in for the Eskimos. And the Alouettes send their usual two deep men down. Joey Powell, number 82, and Pete Karpuk on the left, number 91. There they are, about the 5-yard line, but they'll go a bit deeper than that. Bill Walker is now kicking for Edmonton. Parker has until now. Here's Walker's boot from the 45. It is a honey, very high, to Karpuk on the one. He is snowed under by about four tacklers on roughly the half-yard line. That is the first kick that has exceeded 40 yards, going roughly 45 yards where Pete took it on the one-yard line and smothered under almost immediately. Alouettes huddling offensively in their own end zone, 10 yards in. Edmonton forward wall gets set about 2 yards from the Alouette goal line. Joey Pal is a flanker on this side. And the handoff drives across the five-yard line. Comes up to about the seven, Bob Pascal, number 86, the ball carrier. A stop is made for Edmonton, principally by Art Walker, number 50, who plays left tackle defensively. 7-6 is the count, Montreal over Edmonton. Patterson scored, Bewley converted. Bright scored for Edmonton, and Mobram missed the convert. Mr. Abruzzi was just plain, swarmed under, stopped just about the line of scrimmage. Might have lost half a yard. About four men in the front of the Edmonton forward wall grabbed hold of him, made no mistake about it, and he got absolutely nowhere. Led by Frankie Morris, number 52, the middle guard. So it's third down and 5 yards to go. Miles and Mendrick are the deep men. If you can call deep the Montreal 40-yard line, that's where they're standing. Etcheverry booting is 10 yards in his own end zone. Bill Walker in very fast caused Sam for the second time this afternoon to get that ball off the side of his foot, and it traveled out only to the 31-yard line where Edmonton takes possession, first and 10 on the Alouettes 31. Varsity Stadium in Toronto is jam-packed this afternoon, and the weather, it's just about perfect. Getty quarterbacking. Second man, Jackie Parker gets it, finds a nice hole off right tackle and drives down. Bewley hit him first and upset him, and Bruce Colder completed the job. But Mr. Parker's gain is, it's about 9.5 yards. It is less than a yard short of a first down. Getty still quarterbacking. Johnny Bright picks up the necessary yardage off right guard, and his charge carried him to the 18-yard line. Edmonton, first and 10. Tommy Hugo talks up defensive signals for Montreal, number 48. Art Walker threw a nice block that sprung Bright loose for the yardage necessary for that first down. Normie Kwong is the ball carrier across the 15 to about the 13-yard line. Piled up there. Blacher, number 81, is the first man to get him. Right inside linebacker for the Alouettes, John Blacher. The gain is a good 5, maybe 6 yards. Ball on the 13, dead in front of the goalpost. Pitch out to Bright, cuts back. He's across the 10, down to about the 7-yard line, and man, there's a real big pileup. That should be a first down, but let's wait until they do unpile. So signaled by the referee. First down. Jimmy Miller led the defensive work for the Alouettes there. And Edmonton finds itself once again knocking on touchdown door. On the 7-yard line, first and goal to go. They trail 6-7. Parker is down to about the 2-yard line, very close to the goal line. Jackie seemed to be stopped on about the 2-yard line, but flung himself forward and can't be more than about half a yard. The ball put down on the one. So it is second down and goal to go, a yard out, and the Alouettes send in Tex Colder, number 60, and Charlie Gibbons, number 52, to strengthen the center of that line. Blacher comes out, and so does Colder. Alouettes will pack the forward wall. Ted Reddell says it looks as though the Alouettes are going to play a 12-man line on this, and he's not very far wrong. The officials chasing photographers back. Out of the end zone, they had crept halfway in. Here's the picture, just a yard from touchdown territory. Edmonton on the march. Getty quarterbacking on a sneak. The Edmonton Eskimos, the Grey Cup champions, moved 33 yards on just six plays for their second TD of the afternoon. Johnny Tatum, the Edmonton offensive center, made the block that enabled Don Getty, the quarterback, on the sneak to count the second TD of the day for the Eskies. The convert attempt by Joe Mubra, number 77. Getty holding. Joe missed the first one. High pass from center. It is no good. It goes to the right of the upright. And the score is Edmonton 12, Montreal 7. That is the second time this afternoon that Joe Mubra, a newcomer to the Eskies this year, has failed to boot the conversion. It is 12-7, and we have roughly 11 minutes left to go in the second quarter. Mubra on the kickoff. Pal Patterson and James, the Alouettes' deep men, at the 10-yard line. Here we go. To Hal Patterson on the 6. At the 15, coming this way. At the 20. 25, puts his head down, still going. And he is down on the 36-yard line. And at least four Eskimos hit him on the way between the 25 and the 36, where he was finally stopped principally by Mike King, number 55. 29-yard run back by Hal Patterson. For those of you in the West who have not seen this great football player in action on kickoff returns, that was a pretty fair indication. Edmonton employing a 5-4-3 defense against the Alouettes, who send Bob Pascoe very wide. And, man, he got absolutely nowhere. There may have been a crisscross in signals. Bob James was the ball carrier, and he ran smack into the Reed Henderson, the big fellow for the Edmonton Eskimos, number 65 at left tackle. Biggest man on the squad, 240-pounder. James is not so big. Mr. Echeverry back, throwing a wobbler to James. He's got it, a great catch on the 50-yard line. That is only the third completion for Echeverry this afternoon in 10 attempts, a far cry from the Grey Cup game last year when he completed 30 out of 39 for a new all-time record. And Mubra is the man who stopped Bob James. Right on the Alouettes 50-yard line, first and 10. And the stadium, particularly the Montreal side of it, begins to buzz again. Sam slips. The turf in midfield, it must be noted, is very definitely just a wee bit greasy, enough so that footing is sometimes a little bit delicate. Roger Nelson made sure that Sam didn't go any farther. Right tackle both ways for the Eskimos, number 66. Loss in the play is pretty close to 3 yards, second and 13. Pascal flanks to the far side. Joey Powell out here at Echeverry back to throw it. A screen pass to Abruzzi. Beautiful shift by Abruzzi. Look at that one. He left that tackler, who was Oscar Kruger, just in his tracks. And finally is down on the 39-yard line. Key block thrown by Charlie Gibbons, number 52. That is a play the Alouettes have employed with great, great success this year, particularly with a Abruzzi carrying. And his zigzag tactics there caught the Eskimos a wee bit flat-footed. Two flankers go out. The fireman is James Powell inside. Pascal carries and nailed just as he crossed the line of scrimmage. His pickup may be a couple of yards, but no more. Roger Nelson, number 66, is the key man of three on the stop. And number 42, Johnny Tatum, plays left inside linebacker defensively and is Edmonton's offensive center. A first-year man and a very good one. The gain is a little more than a yard. Let's make it second and about nine. Echeverry on the 45, looking and throwing very deep, intended for Patterson. He's got it! Echeverry to Patterson traveled about 70 yards in the air, and that is one of the unbelievable catches that Prince Hal is able to make, and certainly does. Conversion by Bill Buehle is good. Patterson got behind Oscar Kruger, the deep defensive man, and Oscar is wandering around in front of the goalpost, shaking his head, asking himself how that could happen, as the scoreboard at Varsity Stadium, with about 9 minutes to go in the second quarter, shows 14-12 for Montreal. Well, there's no need to tell you the roar that went up. Ted Reynolds is shaking his head as well. He knows how Kruger feels. He doesn't believe it. Actually speaking, there are many of us who believe very firmly that Patterson, using a basketball tactic, deliberately tipped the ball to get it out of the possible hands of an interceptor and then grabs onto it himself. It looked as if it might have been that way that time. Parker and Miles are the deep men for Edmonton. Johnny Blacher's kick to Parker at the 10, at the 25, up the middle, and he's across and finally down on about the 34-yard line in a big pileup. Bob McClellan, number 62, and Ted Elsby, 67. The two men who submarined on Parker and brought him down. Edmonton ball first and 10 from their own 33-yard line. Don Getty quarterbacking. Johnny Bright on a fast handoff, hits right into the center of the line. Is across the 35. Jim Staton, number 63. Hobbling on an injured leg was the principal tackler. The pickup is 3 yards. It is second down and 7 to go. Raleigh Miles goes flanking on the far side. Getty is back, looks, throws down, and it is tipped by Tommy Hugo. Intended for Bill Walker, the offensive right end of the Eskimos. Hugo got his left hand up and just tipped it out of Walker's reach. The kicking team goes in for Edmonton. Karpuk and Pal, there they are, in for Montreal. 91 Karpuk, 82 Pal. Unofficially, there is 8 minutes and 15 seconds to halftime. It is 14-12 Montreal. Two touchdowns, both converted. Two touchdowns for the Eskimos, neither one made good. Parker kicking from about his 25. Goes out of bounds, and the officials line it up, and they say on the Alouettes 52-yard line. This is something we haven't pointed out before. Jackie Parker is wearing very thin, light gloves this afternoon. He is the only man on the field so doing. Montreal ball, first and 10. The football is 15 yards in from the far eastern sideline. Edmonton employing a 5-4-3 defense against the Alouettes right now. Pitch out comes to Pat Abruzzi. Nice block, springs him loose. O'Quinn through the block. Look at that switch by Abruzzi again. And he drives down across the Edmonton 50-yard line. Pat is much shiftier in this ball game than we've seen him all year here in the East. Art Walker, number 50, principal man who dragged him down. And that Walker is a great ball player for Edmonton. Bob Pascal pulls his way down, and the whistle had blown. He lost control of the football, but the whistle had blown. He got a first down on the 45-yard line. Frankie Anderson, left guard of Edmonton, number 51, the man who got him. And Anderson is very slow getting up. Anderson wears a special corset from his hip right to his shoulder. Etcheverry back. Throwing deep again, and in the clear is Pascal, who loses the ball. It's recovered by Edmonton, and they scramble for it on the 25-yard line. Edmonton possession. Oscar Kruger is the man who recovered for Edmonton, right on their 25-yard line and 15 yards in from the far side. 7 minutes unofficially to halftime, 14-12, Montreal. That is the first fumble of the ball game. Getty quarterbacking. Driving into the right side, the left side of his own line, the ball carrier Normie Kwong picked up maybe 2 yards, just about. Montreal's line and their defense close to the line is shifting. They were employing almost a 9-man line on that last play. Now they're in about an 8-4. There's a marker on this play. The ball carrier is Rollie Miles, and the tackle is made by number 77, Tommy Moran. The Eskimos are offside on it. There is the signal. Edmonton offside. It is declined by the Alouettes. The referee today is Harry Bowden of Toronto. The three umpires, Norm Crichton of Hamilton, Bill Nairn and Cliff Roseborough of Winnipeg, field judge Paul Dojak of Regina, head linesman Bob Lai of Hamilton. Karpuk and Pal at their own 35-yard line. And let's see who'll boot this time. It's Jackie Parker standing on his 15. A poor kick, landing at midfield, taken by Karpuk, and he is spilled at midfield. So the Alouettes will take possession there, first and 10. The score, Montreal 14, Edmonton 12. Sam has still got the football. Lateral goes out to Pascal. He is nailed by Bill Rokamp on a honey of a tackle. Rokamp broke through after Etcheverry had lateraled to Bob Pascal. And the loss in the play is roughly 2 yards. So it is second down and 12. And the football is down exactly on the 52-yard line. Varsity Stadium for this Grey Cup game this year is marked off 15 yards in from each sideline, each yard all the way through the 110 of the gridiron. Etcheverry looking, throwing a bullet-like pass intended for Joey Powell. And it was tipped out there. Tatum, number 42. And Bob Kimoff, number 80, was also right in on top of it. So the Alouettes come up with a punting situation. And number 73, Steve Mendrick. And number 98, Rollie Miles, are the receivers set up by Edmonton. Kimoff is playing defense in place of the injured Earl Lindley. Sam boots a floater close to the sideline, and stepping out is Steve Mendrick on the 26-yard line. Ted, I know that out west, fellows like Earl Lindley, Gino Frakes, particularly, are very anxious about the result of this ball game. Two Edmonton players who are not with the club in the big one that they would love to play in most. We certainly send along our regret that they can't be participating along with their fine teammates, and we certainly hope they enjoy the television coverage of the Grey Cup here in Toronto. Pitch out is by Getty to Raleigh Miles. Look at that little boy scamper. And he is dumped down on the 37-yard line. And it was actually a block that Hal Patterson threw at his feet. It is a first down, Miles picking it up. Raleigh Miles is listed in the programs as weighing 175. That is a little doubtful. He may not be that big. Johnny Bright on a fast direct handoff hits into right tackle on his own line and is up to the 40-yard line, a pickup of maybe three. We are very close to the five-minute mark to the end of the second quarter. Officials are having a little trouble. It looks like a tag team wrestling match out there with all participants in the ring at the same time. Arms and legs just sort of tangled up. There's the five-minute signal right now. Alouettes in front by 2 points, 14 to 12. Pitch out to Parker from Getty. Look at that boy go. Pitch out to Miles at the 40, 45, 50, out of bounds. On the 53-yard line, pushed out by Jimmy Miller. Defensive left end for Montreal. And somebody could have been racked up just a little bit on that play on the far side. That Miles is a real scooter. Ted points out one perhaps oddity about Miles. He almost always carries the ball with two hands. Edmonton being penalized for rough play. There's Harry Bowden's signal. Back to the 40-yard line. It is first down for Edmonton on their own 40-yard line. Miles had gone out of bounds on the 53. Johnny Bright, the ball carrier on a bruising run up the center, picks up 9 yards. It is second down and a little more than 1 yard left to go. Normie Kwong, number 85. And a marker goes down for piling by one of the defensive players in the Montreal Alouettes. The official standing right over the situation caught the infraction, and the marker went down on the field. That moves the ball on the roughing penalty. Down to the Montreal 42-yard line, Tommy Hugo having a conversation with referee Harry Bowden about the call. Getty has still got it, firing out intended for Miles way over his head. And the man diving for it was Jack Dwyer, number 89 of the Montreal Alouettes. Plays defensive left halfback. Don Getty pulling right back, looking and throwing very deep down, intended for Miles. It is intercepted. Bruce Calder grabbed it on the 8, got up, and advanced it back to the 17-yard line. And Miles, who was the intended receiver, came back and grabbed Calder and brought him down. Tommy Moran and Bruce Calder running off together right there. Oh, Only two interceptions today, both have been by Bruce Coulter, who hasn't been used too much this year, perhaps. Etcheverry throwing a wobbler, intercepted by Tully. He's back to the 25 and spins around to the 23-yard line where Trowick makes sure he is stopped. Man who hit him first was Tommy Hugo. Frank Anderson, who is noted, as Doug McNichol is here in the East, for his ability at rushing a passer, was in very fast on Sam, and Etcheverry threw an unusual wobbler. And Tully, number 70 for Edmonton, Johnny on the spot for the interception, number 3 of the game. Edmonton's ball, first and 10 on the Alouette 24-yard line, about 3 minutes to go. A marker on this play, right the ball carrier, high into the air. The Eskimos offside. A check between the officials on the calling of the play. Harry Bowden is consulting with Tommy Hugo, acting captain of the Alouettes. And here's the mark off. Back to the 29-yard line, and the signal offside against Edmonton. Alouettes are in front by 2 points, 14 to 12, on the strength of two missed conversions by the Eskies. The play moving this way, the pitch out to Miles, he juggled it, hang on. Cuts back nicely to the 25-yard line. Stopped by Tom Hugo, number 48, first man to hit him. Reed Henderson threw the nice block in the backfield that enabled him to get down almost to the 25. 3 minute signal just given from the field. Incidentally, there is fine entertainment lined up here at halftime for you, so don't go too far away from your television set. Doug Maxwell, Ted Reynolds, and yours truly will be discussing what has happened. And from Eddie Fitkin's fine statistics, we'll keep you up to date on facts and figures, too. Normie Kwong with Getty hiding the ball beautifully and holding it to the last split second. Kwong hit through a hole between guard and tackle on the right side and is downed on the 21-yard line by Jimmy Miller and Tom Hugo. Mobra is coming in. This may be for a field goal attempt by the Eskimos. Joe Mobra, number 77, left end offensively, has missed both conversions today. This would be a chance to really get those misses back if he could boot a field goal, but he's coming back off the field now. There's a possibility, too, that Jackie Parker could try a field goal. The ball is dead in front of the upright. Third down and about 8 to go. This is going to be it. Parker will try it. The ball will be down on the 28-yard line. High pass. No good. Patterson in there. Brings it out to the 5 and down. A nice tackle on the 6-yard line. Jimmy Shipka, number 83, is the man who got Hal Patterson. And the Eskimos are having rough luck so far today insofar as trying to get the football over the crossbar and between the uprights. The Alouettes have it first and 10 on their own 6-yard line. It's 15 yards in, as you can see, where those markers are from these western sidelines. 2 minutes and about 20 seconds unofficially left to go to the half. Etcheverry throwing very long, intended for Patterson. And he and Rokamp were in there, and they're calling interference on Bill Rokamp, who doesn't like the call. Etcheverry threw that football approximately 40 yards. And on the interference call that referee Bowden is giving you right now, Rokamp is the culprit. It gives Alouettes a first down on their 40-yard line and certainly takes a whale of a lot of pressure off them, for they were deep in their own territory on the 6 when they started. Etcheverry still got it. Anderson put the rush on him, but he ducked him. A long one for Powell. Almost completed. Parker almost had an interception as well. Very good guarding by Jackie Parker on Joey Pell. On pass defense for Edmonton, Jackie Parker probably covers more ground than any other football player on the field, with the exception of his Eastern counterpart, Hal Patterson. He floats all over the place. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the Alouettes' 40-yard line. A minute, 45 seconds left. 14-12, Montreal. Etcheverry will throw again. Anderson after him again. He threw a screen pass out here intended for a Abruzzi, but threw it about 2 yards behind him. And checking very closely on a Abruzzi was Reed Henderson, number 65, and Bob Kimoff, number 80. Echeverry on his 26-yard line. Mendrick and Miles deep for Edmonton. High spiral. Mendrick on the 27-yard line. Starts for the far side. Is hit by Doug McNichol with a flying block that knocks him to the earth on the 32. And Gibbons, number 52, made sure he stayed there. And Mendrick is shaken up but good on that play. Roughly 1 minute and 20 seconds to halftime, 14-12, Montreal. Mendrick, number 73, used as a left half defensively, and as a punt receiver, was hit a tremendous flying block by big Doug McNichol, who only goes, I'd say, Hal, about 245 or 50 at least on 6'4". So when he hits you, you really feel it. Steve coming off under his own steam. Number 71, Steve Bendiak, going in for Edmonton. Eskies have the ball, first and 10 from their own 32 and a half yard line. Getty quarterbacking. Pitch out is to Miles. Miles out to Parker. He's at the 45 yard line. And there's going to be a roughing penalty called here against Montreal. It will be the second time the same type of penalty has been called for unnecessary piling on. Hal Patterson made the stop, and the officials begin the march downfield. This time, Juan Sheridan, acting captain, along with Tom Hugo, is talking to referee Harry Bowden about it. Sheridan takes his helmet off, still has a few words to say. Eskimos ready to go offensively. Sheridan isn't ready. He's still talking to the officials. All right. The minute flag has just gone up on the sidelines. Pass completed from Gehi to Miles, who gets away from the first man. And Bewley came in from behind to drag him down. Eskimos on the march again. It's a first down on the 30-yard line. 15 yards in from the far side. The time is less than 60 seconds. Johnny Bright at a big hole opens up, and man, does he go. He's all the way down to the 13-yard line. One of the Alouettes hurt in the play, getting up all right. 6'1", 215 pounds. Johnny Bright, when he moves remarkably fast, carries a powerful wallop. First and 10 on the 14-yard line. Bright again. Stopped on approximately the 9. There can't be too much time left. The clock here at Varsity Stadium shows no time remaining. It stops actually at the minute mark. And that flag has been up. The ball is on the 10-yard line. A great chance for Edmonton to move ahead at halftime here if they can do it. Getty throwing. Completed to Parker for a touchdown. Jackie Parker took that just about a yard out in the middle of Bruce Colter, Hal Patterson, and Tommy Moran, and spun himself into the end zone. We'll see what Mr. Mobrook can do this time. It is 18-14 Edmonton. Can he make it 19? He does. And so as time is just about up at the end of the first half, it is Edmonton 19, Montreal 14. As the gun sounds to end the first half with the score, the Edmonton Eskimos 19, the Montreal Alouettes 14.
Up to myself, Billy.